you been looking forward to perform visual grouping in a powerful grid that you can use not only in VCL, Delphi or C++ Builder Windows applications, but also in cross-platform scenarios with the FireMonkey framework targeting Windows, macOS, Linux, iOS and Android? Well, this video is especially for you. I will show you how, with the latest version of our FNC Data Grid, you can perform visual grouping. How you can do that is by enabling the header, adding the header to your grid, and from there you can drag columns to perform visual grouping in the grid header. You can also perform the sorting from the groups in the header. And finally, you can also add any buttons or controls in that header area and perform, for example, custom actions from there. Interested? Well, let's dive into the Delphi IDE and I will show you everything in detail. So here I am in the Delphi 12.3 IDE and I have an empty project already prepared for you with a couple of components added to be able to connect to a database, here in this case, a simple access database with the FD table, the FireDeck table, and that connects to the access database via the FireDeck connection. And of course, the table is connected to the data source. And now I'm going to add the FNC data grid on the form. Here it is. Let's make it a little bit bigger. And to connect to the database, I will add the FNC data grid database adapter. As I drop it on the form, you can see that the data adapter was automatically assigned to the grid adapter property, so it is ready to be used. What I need to do is also connect the data source component to my data adapter, and as I do that, you can see that it already shows the columns and the data of my table. The only fine-tuning that I will do is change the width of these columns a little bit to make more columns visible, as you can see now. So I simply opened the column editor and changed the width for all columns. As I will be doing grouping, I need to change the load mode of my data adapter to all records, because of course the grouping will have to be performed on all records in the data set. So let's introduce now the visual grouping feature. Visual grouping is performed from the grid header. So we move to the header property that you can find here, and you can see that it has the bar property and the visual grouping property. When I make the header visible like this, can see it appear on top of the grid. And as I explained, two parts. It has the part to perform visual grouping. That means I can drag my columns into that gridded header visual grouping area. And in addition, I also have the bar property. A bar is a bar of controls or buttons. I can also make that visible, and you see an extra bar appear from where you can add additional controls or buttons to that header, which we will not be using yet here in this first introduction. What I also need to do to let you get started with visual grouping is enable column dragging, because we will want that you can perform dragging of columns into that grouping, visual grouping area in the header. And for that, I enable column dragging that you can find under grid.options. Note that if you do not allow this interaction via column dragging with your header, your header with visual grouping can still be used to visualize the grouping in your grid. So if you would programmatically do the grouping, you would still see, when you open the header, of course, when you make it visible, you would still see the grouping in effect. You can just not interact with it via dragging columns into that grid area. So that's all I actually needed to do to get started with grouping. And so I can simply drag columns into my grouping area and the header, and for example create groups like this. So now we have created a grouping based on two column conditions, the brand column and the cylinder column. I can also invoke two level grouping by simply dragging the column here to the next level, the level under it, and you will see that now it has two levels of grouping. At this moment I cannot perform sorting from this group, but when I enable the sorting in the grid and I enable, let's go to grid options.sorting here, and let's enable the sorting, and let's also check here in visual grouping that I can perform sort on click. That is already true. And when I now run this application, I can do also this extra capability of sorting in the header. So here you can see that I perform the sort by clicking on the group header, and you can also of course perform the sorting by clicking on the header columns. So that simple it is, a couple of properties, nothing more than that, to enable visual grouping in your FNC Data Grid in VCL Windows applications, but also in cross-platform FireMonkey applications with Delphi or C++ Builder, as our FNC Data Grid can of course be used in both scenarios. Actually, there is even a third scenario that you can use. You can use it in a TMS Web Core web client applications. Now, let's pick a more extensive sample, and actually this sample builds up upon the sample that we already provided for regular grouping. We extended it with visual grouping, and I will show you also the capability to add controls in the bar in the header of the grid. So you can see here three buttons, buttons from where I add calculations to the grid. You can see here that I'm basically here adding a count calculation. You can see it here, and here I add a sum calculation to a specific column in the grid. That is triggered from clicking that button. You can see the other buttons, they will perform collapsing all nodes and expanding all nodes. So what is happening here? Let's maybe first go over the initialization real quick. You can see that I'm loading data here from a CSV file, so you can not only perform grouping of course for data that comes from a connected data set, but you can also load any data in the grid and perform the grouping on it. And here you can see actually where the header bar is made visible, and a couple of controls are added to the grid header bar. You can see that I have also enabled column dragging. That of course will enable me to drag columns into the grid visual grouping area and perform the grouping from there. Let's maybe first run this application and see everything in effect. The first thing that I wanted to show you is when I perform programmatic grouping, which is done by selecting on which column I will group, you can see here in the header, in the visual grouping area of the grid header, that it shows you the grouping that was performed programmatically. So it's always in sync what you do via dragging in the visual grouping area, or what you do programmatically, it's kept in sync. And here I can also close the grouping via the visual grouping area. And of course, if I remove all the grouping from there, and I will, for example, perform the grouping like this via column dragging, you can see the here, in this case, a three-level grouping that was performed by the dragging into the visual grouping area in the grid. So from here, I can also trigger calculations. So you can see here that in my subgrids, in the grouped subgrids, it shows you the calculations, and I can perform the collapsing and expanding of all my groups via these buttons. And with that, I hope you're as excited as I am about this new visual grouping capability. So not longer you are constrained to performing the grouping programmatically. Now you can let your users freely play with all the grouping capabilities, sort from these groups, add extra controls in the header of the grid to perform extra functionality. And I think with that, our FNC data grid just got a whole lot stronger. Explore the FNC data grid. There is a free, fully functional trial version of it in the TMS FNC UI pack. And if you want to stay updated on everything that's happening around our FNC controls, our FNC data grid, don't forget to subscribe to this video channel. You will be notified when we have new content for you. And of course, we also invite you to like this video. Thanks for watching, until the next video.